You should leave right now. In case you need to leave in the middle of the performance, you should be asked the reason why. Just a small feedback. Representative of what you are.
Something like that. I suggest that we all try to introduce ourselves to the other room over there by a gesture or a movement that we think it is representative of ourselves.
Whoever wants to come and begin, just a small gesture, something.
Okay, so let's form two other groups and then Okay, now from the non-artists, the curators will go over there, and the non-curators will go over there.
Συντροφιά μαυρομάτα The score talks about narcissism. Does anyone have any comments they can make about narcissism and contemporaneity?
Mm-hmm.
I'm just interested in.
Okay, let's make a step. Enough.
I'm just interested in the score because it talks about narcissism and it being as the score. Just wondering how people interpret that score and how it talks about narcissism being wrapped up in contemporaneity somehow. People agree.
Great.
But you, obviously, by not being on it, you still can be narcissistic, but I just wonder how you operate on it. I don't know.
Is that because you're the one person?
Yeah, that's what I was like, conceptually, yeah. No, but that's a form of narcissism too, like opting out, like I'm not going to reveal any of myself to you, because you're taking a risk every time on social media that you might perform yourself in some way that is not kind of interesting to people and doesn't produce likes or produces negative response as well. So it's, I don't think I'm exceptional. I'm just not taking the risk.
I think narcissism is broader than just like social media. Culture is narcissistic in every way. So by social media is just one aspect of a bad thing shifted to narcissist.
Can you have tried to speak up?
What are the other platforms in which people are narcissistic?
Just genuine behavior.
Towards each other.
Yeah.
But it could be also in terms of politics. Like, Metin seems to be counterpoising it to social collective narcissism, so maybe it's about neoliberalism or something like that. Are you narcissists?
No, I wouldn't possibly do
that. Many people, a lot of mothers aren't, a lot of parents aren't. Mm-hmm. But there's a platform now for everyone to think their opinion is broadcast worthy. Which is a good thing, because hero worship existed always before that. So the mouthpiece was unilateral or was controlled by power systems. So if we now have the mouthpiece, but the power system and the surface area of that platform is controlled by interests that we don't even know about. So it's there's something insidious and scary about it. But narcissism is used as a very negative term in cultures in around in different parts of the world. They relate to self-interest differently.
But the word is Greek. And it used to have a negative story.
Sure.
About the mirror.
He's punished.
It was natural.
He fell in love with his own.
He tried to kiss himself and he cried. Mm-hmm.
Decentralize ourselves through this process, but I don't know, do you feel like Documenta has been successful for that, in that sense?
We're
all
speaking English, I want to have a great experience. Are there any people who don't speak English? So bright in here.
I need to make a question.
Do you believe that social dissonance needs to be created? Isn't there like already?
And I will reply.
Isn't there a theory that people who come together for shows like Documenta agree to participate in an artwork like this are unlikely to be socially dissonant?
Unlikely.
Okay, so let's continue with the questions.
It's funny that you've acted like the people not interested in being active to ask the questions. It seems like it's an onerous responsibility for an active show. That's creating.
Well, because we can also give you instructions like that.
Is that
So everyone jump up and then lie down on the ground.
We don't have to do
that.
That's an instruction.
Are we it was a cat. Yes. It was a question. We're allowed to instruct.
We're allowed to instruct.
Why am I good with this?
Okay.
But we can't enforce.
100%.
Or can I ask you all to like jump up and then lie down?
Can we go back to that social dissonance question? Because I feel like we started something and then we didn't get to it. I think that the system, big T, big S, it's what's the word? It's designed to lower resistance, to shape our behaviors around avoiding resistance. And so we become less aware of, like, this is what you're shining a light in this situation, which is helpful to look at social dissonance. But the real social dissonance that could speak are discouraged by all of the intuitive design of living and contouring
of like capitalist interests. So we just, but we're not really understanding it yet. So it's an exercise. But I can see like you here doing this and I'm not really unsafe. I'm a lucky privileged person here. So it's a nice exercise, but we're not really under threat.
Do you believe that everybody here is privileged people?
I just mean that it's an exercise to shine a light on power structures, social strata, and everything, but done in a safe environment.
Have any of you done something that you feel socially dissonant over the past couple of weeks? Could you act it out?
To be accountable actions that I've previously done, that changes how you conceive of the present moment.
If it's free to use in the future, what is the usefulness of the material? I mean, how do we imagine it could be used?
I don't understand. How it's matched?
Yeah, you said it's, that why it's being strained is because this material is free to be used. Mm-hmm. I'm asking, how is this material useful? In what way can it be used?
It can be anything. Somebody needs the footage to, I don't know, edit porn or something. Or anything, maybe he wants his children to go to sleep and say, eat your food, look at these people, what they're doing.
To send children to sleep. That's
I think it's more that scary.
It's a new lullaby.
Okay.
So let's continue with questions.
Can you do the gesture or the movement that you do the first thing in the morning?
Sorry, what?
stress for
What are you doing?
I'm a service animal. And lots of deadlines. So, I go to sleep every night.
Can we ask some questions?
Yeah.
I don't like interrogation.
Do you like exchange your life with someone else?
Someone very much rich. very richer than
for your own life.
For your own life.
Mm-hmm.
And you stop at the beginning.
For a week.
For a week.
We're a very virtuous group.
And who complain about his own life?
Supposed to be understanding social dissonance better through this process.
We have a universally agreed definition of social dissonance.
You want us to ask the other people if they have understood anything so far?
Hi! We have a question here.
Hi guys, do we have a universal definition of social dissonance? Are they saying?
Are you listening? Okay, we can comment on them.
Social dissonance is already in the context of the work,
so
and the problem is it's very hard to sort of do anything real or meaningful in this space because of the dissonance that is sort of, you know, quite, that characterizes our relations to one another already. So it's a bit.
So we could potentially then think about it in that we're here collectively, so we could come up with some dissonant action to take out to the world that could essentially be positive. I don't have any ideas for that, but we're still thinking about it, like between us, the dissonance between us in this room.
It's also,
but it doesn't have to be.
Probably within the group, there's not that many very snap oppositional relations. Here is this event, which means that we're probably coming from a certain demography. It's not like we're different tribes within South Sudan and we're sitting in a room together. So, like, the potential for social dissonance is much friendlier and more alike.
I just don't know each other.
yourself as these things are supposed that you're going to just be, or I'm going to walk away and probably never see each other again.
I think the idea that it can be external is insane. I mean, this is just like the academicization of the fact that you can talk about something that's happening outside of our bodies and outside of our experience. Like, that is just constantly. But you're constantly trying to, but we, I mean, I feel like it's like we're trying to pull it back into our bodies.
There's supposed to be a musical score with each of us as instruments. Like, that's what's proposed in the work. And so, how, what kind of music is being produced?
All of our preset notions of entertainment and relationship and filling space. This is all the polyphony we're hearing right now. I mean, we're all just responding as we should. I suppose I'm a bit frustrated because I wonder how many people would benefit from this who aren't, and I'm making assumptions about all of us here, but who aren't mostly privileged people. What I'm taking from this is a wonderful gift, but I wish that other people might be able to experience this, because as a person who's involved with arts, I'm exposed to this line of questioning all the time. And I feel like it falls on deaf ears on some levels. Not because I'm like enlightened, but it'd be good if this was experienced by a lot of other kinds of people.
What are you taking from this? What's the
answer? I'm not sure I'm finding it that useful. I'm just being honest. I mean, I think it's interesting. I think we're being polite. I'm probably being impolite now, but it's just a reflective, we are narcissists looking at ourselves. We're looking into a blank space and it's speaking back at us. So there's a Lacanian who's told us a bit about Lacan, maybe.
When you say taking this out, so you're saying something that's missing, how would you do that? How do we open up this space in this conversation?
That's a question for things like Documenta, I suppose. And
what is it about Documenta that's not inclusive enough, that's not going in? Like, this is our, we just came today, like, we haven't been in Athens, we were like, cool, an event, let's check it out. So
yes.
What is it that's wrong?
I think that there's also, it's hard for me to say because often these things are bred for my consumption. But for people who don't have access or don't live within the breathing space of these kinds of events.
Well, I actually see that today on the it's my favorite kind of craft, because they always expect something exotic, they have the experience, they have all this thing. And they miss all the understanding point. I think that today was one of the most beneficial days we had this 2 months. It goes well when it's silent, because every single person that has a problem sticks out like a toothpick. It was obvious who didn't like it. It was obvious who didn't want to participate, who wanted to go a step further, which makes it so much pungent, this thing that we're trying to do. So all in all, maybe it wasn't as active as I would like it to be, but I think the point, the message, was able to go across. It's always different what people expect, even for us. For me today, what I gained from this experience was that the kind of audience that's the most easy to play with are the ones that do not want to be here. It's always the easiest target. How about you?
Okay, it's obvious that today we lost some of the tension we should have created because of the playfulness of the audience. There was a playful spirit in the group, but still I think we, with this group thinking in the end, we approached very much the thread. But the case is that, of course, it was very clear to me the difficulty and the problem of connecting all these people together, and the problem of, you know, asking people to ask some questions to people that they don't want to learn anything from. It was so clear that everybody did not want to connect with the other people in the other room. Nobody wanted to ask something about them because they didn't care. We didn't care. I didn't care. It's obvious. And after that, it is also obvious that people are waiting for something to happen. They're waiting to consume something. They feel like taking control of the situation in order for something to happen, but they cannot. I mean, yeah, we had all of this today, so yeah, it was very interesting from this point of view. And yeah. And of course, there were some people that took over that were more confident. I don't know, you said something about you bringing people here. You invited some of the people in the audience. Okay, so I guess you have this confidence to speak in a public about, in a public that you have invited here about arts that you are involved in, and you also were very confident, and you said many times how privileged we are all in here, but still we are in, I guess, in comparison to the world's population, like, yeah. But still, it is also something that we bring. I mean, yeah. I don't think that, for example, we, that we are Athenians, that we live in Greece, we feel so much privileged in this context. But yeah, somebody with a better, you know, a better use of the language, or a better, you know, background, more privileged background, can bring it here to this context and can also project it as it is universal, like, yeah, but it's not. And what else? And the singing, very nice girl. it was like we asked something to consume. In the end.
Καλά, εσύ ακόμη στέλνεις, να αγώνεσαι.
Ναι.